It was seen in the press about planning applications, the concreting over of our green and pleasant land. Local press, oh, for all right, planning applications gone in. Over there, look, there are 200-300 homes needed on that side of town. Following year, a couple of years later, they want 400 homes now over there. Year after that, another 100 here, another 400 there the following year. What do we need all those homes for? Why are they all being built around here where I live? It's not just where you live. If you travel around the country at all, you'll see it's everywhere. Look in your national press, you start regional spatial strategies, telling you how many tens of thousands of new homes you need in every regional area around the country. They've been done away with now. You've got planning policy initiatives. You've got new documents coming out telling you about the planning strategies. How are we going to concrete over more of England? More and more and more of it, as those green fields have got to go under the developers' bulldozers. You must have asked yourself why. Well, you should be asking yourself why. Yes, 30, 40 years ago, we were told social patterns of living are changing. And they were right. Couples aren't staying together like they used to. Families are splitting up. People are opting to live alone. That is factually correct. Look around you. There's no question of it. Tell you something else, though. And they do report this. It's out there. It's on the Office of National Statistics website, if you wish to go and look it up. The indigenous population of the United Kingdom is shrinking. It shrinks every year, goes down every year, and has done for 30 years. Hang on. So if the population is going down, why does the number of houses need to keep going up at such a rate? And the answer, of course, is immigration. Oh, this is just a right-wing immigration rant. No, it isn't. I want you to think of it. I don't care how you vote, that's your business. But think about this. If the indigenous population goes down, the total population continues to rise by the population of the metropolitan area of Leeds every year, which is about 500,000. That's a massive demographic change in your country. That's a massive increase on the infrastructure. The increase in burden on the infrastructure is why it's creaking the way it is. Think about it. Now, I've got friends, frankly, that are socialists. And they will say to you, they've often said to me, Martin, you've got it wrong, it's a good thing. The diversity that it brings is brilliant. Well, you know what? They're talking now and they're going, you know, maybe there's enough diversity. I ask you the question, how many languages do you need spoken in your schools? My answer is irrelevant. What's your answer? You've got to vote. Come the next general election, next European election. I want you to simply think about where you're going to put it. What type of candidate are you going to vote for? If you're going to vote Lib Dem, Labour, Conservative, the traditional three main British parties, then you're voting for the continuance of the immigration, the large scale, year on year immigration into your nation. You are voting for that, no question. They want it for different reasons, beyond the scope of this clip, it'd be half an hour long. They want it for different reasons, but they're all pro-immigration. If the level of immigration concerns you, you need to look elsewhere. No point going further left. Communism, socialist workers, no point going there. You're going to have to look, as you probably view it, over to the right wing of the political spectrum. There's a whole spectrum of nationalist parties out there. Find yourself a nationalist party to have a look at. See what they're saying. When it comes round to your election, if you've got a nationalist candidate, don't poo-poo the idea. Don't look at it and go, oh, no, I know what I've been told about them. Have a look. Have a look in depth. Ask them questions. Yeah, some of them are idiots. That goes anywhere. Take a look at the left wing, some of them are idiots. You're going to find that anywhere in the political spectrum. But give them a chance. Please, think about it. Thank you.